One woman who remained unbowed in the face of BBC intractability first wrote to the corporation with a novel idea for a radio talk.
Now meet Queenie and friends of Stoke Mandeville. They've been wearing their winter overcoats during the night, but as it's warmer this morning, their owner, Mrs. Barbara Woodhouse, decides to put them into thinner coats for the day.
Dear Mrs. Woodhouse, we have now fully considered your script, Rugs for Cows, and regret that in view of its comparatively limited appeal, we are unable to find space for it in our programme.
Undaunted, Barbara Woodhouse's response set the tone for her future correspondence.
Dear Mr. Dunnett, thank you very much for your letter and my script. I'm sorry you've had to reject it, as I feel so strongly that it has a very wide appeal. A small letter I wrote 3 years ago, which was published in the Farmer and Stockbreeder, brought me over 300 letters from all over the world. In England, nearly all the daily papers put photographs of the cows before the public, and so many farmers rugged their cows with great success.
If it's wet, the cows wear raincoats. In cold weather, they have jute and wool-lined rugs, while in summer, Mrs. Woodhouse turns them out in cotton. So far, she hasn't bought them any underwear.
Being a doctor's wife, we see so much hardship with old people being short of milk that anything we can do to stop it, we do. Don't bother to answer this. When milk rationing becomes very severe, you may feel this is more important a subject than you think. Yours sincerely, Barbara Woodhouse.
She had more luck with Woman's Hour, where she gave a talk on taking my cows on holiday. But her further suggestions for talks on domestic service, rain, original ideas for children's parties, and men were rejected. Not content with making the odd guest appearance, she wrote to the BBC, offering herself as a regular commentator. However, the powers that be didn't even think she was worth an audition.